here on Watch On Channel, and today I'm back with another review of yet another very nice vintage-inspired dive watch, which was released during 2018. So if you follow my channel, you would know I'm a very big fan of dive watches. I'm a dive watch slut, actually, and I'm a very big fan of vintage-inspired dive watches. I think they have a certain warmth and charm about them. And I'm actually wearing a Christopher Ward C65 Trident vintage-inspired dive watch today, but the review is concerning this Spinnaker Breitner. So Breitner was a very well-known diver. I believe it comes in 5 different versions, and Spinnaker were kind enough to send me this watch. This is a first on this channel, a first Spinnaker review, and I'm very happy they decided to send me the Breitner watch, because I think it's something special, this watch. I'm usually a bit tired of micro brands and these kind of more Asian brands doing a lot of different dive watches. I think it's much of the same, and I'm a bit bored with it. I'm also a bit bored with a lot of the Orient and Seiko dive watches below $300 or $400. I want to admit that. I'm just saying this to actually underline the fact that I really, really like this watch. I think Spinnaker did a stellar job on this watch. So what we have here is a 60s inspired dive watch, automatic dive watch, and it's a compressor diver with internal bezel. That's why you have 2 crowns on this Spinnaker Breitner. So you adjust the bezel inside of the watch, which also gives this watch a lot of dimension. As you can see, it has a lot of depth and almost kind of a 3D effect on the dial, and it's built in layers, which I really like. This is not a very easy watch to build. It's actually more complicated than just building a simple three-handed watch with a date. You see, it's built in layers. You get the dial, and then you actually get applied big applied loom filled hour markings, and then you get the inner ring, which is, it's very hard to see, but you see you get the minute track on the inner ring, and then you get the outer ring with the big minute markings and hour markings, which you use to time your dive, which you adjust by turning the crown here at 2 o'clock. So a 60s inspired compressor dive watch from Spinnaker. It's fitted with a Seiko NH35A movement, which is a very used movement, and you can really be lucky and you can be unlucky with the movement with the Seiko movement. But I think that they actually chose the right movement for this watch to keep the price down, but it's a very robust and tried and tested movement they use. So the dimensions, 42 millimeters in diameter, 44 including the crown, thickness of 14 millimeters, lug width of 20 millimeters, which is very nice because this watch is a strap monster. So you can easily change between straps with 20 millimeters. You can find a lot of strap options, and just approximately 49 to 15 millimeters lock to lock. So all in all, a vintage inspired dive watch with modern dimensions, but not too big. They could easily have gone the full way and just made it a 43 or 44. And that would just be really, really sad. So it wears kind of big because you get the, you don't get a bezel as we usually do on dive watches. You don't get an outer and external bezel, but an internal bezel. Let's have a closer look on the dial. As you can see, as I said, applied hour markings, really thick and really nicely applied, really nicely finished as well. Loom filled hour markings also applied, or minute markings and hour markings, I'm sorry, on the outer part of this kind of very layered dial. Spinnaker at 12 o'clock, a nice negative date window, which is a great thing. A lot of watch companies would just do a black writing on white background, but they actually opted to turn it the reverse. So you get a very kind of subtle but very useful date window at 3 o'clock, and then you get automatic 500 feet, 150 meters of water resistance down here. So it's a 150 meter water resistant watch, which is really cool because that's typical of a vintage inspired dive watch. You only get between 100 and 150 meters, maybe up to 200 meters, like some of the old Tudor and Rolex dive watches. I think it's really nice they didn't go the full way to make it 300 or 400 or 500 or 600 meters, because that's not really vintage inspired. This is a 60s inspired watch. Looking at the case design and the finishing, you get a very nice brushing on the top part of the case, the bezel. Then you get really nice brushing on the side, really industrial kind of tool-like brushing, which really just testaments to this being a vintage-inspired dive watch, which essentially back in the day was a tool watch. I doubt how many people are actually going to dive with this watch today in 2018, but it is truly inspired by watches that were used as a tool. So you get polishing down here again, screw down case back. The Seiko movement inside here, it's not very interesting. It's not a very beautiful movement. They don't finish it very well. So it's kind of a boring movement, but I really actually like that they decided to just do a see-through case back, and then you get a Spinnaker customary black rotor they use on a lot of their watches. So water resistant to 150 meters, sapphire crystal on both sides, big, big plus. Great, great work, Spinnaker. Automatic, all stainless steel. And then you get the two crowns, so with the Spinnaker sail here, it's signed the main crown, which you use to set the time, and then unsigned the crown you use to turn the internal bezel. It comes on this very nice leather strap. It's thick, it's very, very comfortable, and I think it really fits this watch, this particular version of the Breitner collection. I think it really fits it. It just gives it this super nice vintage look, and I think they did a great choice with this leather strap, actually. It's super comfortable and it feels really strong. So signed Spinnaker, and a very interesting detail, it's water-resistant leather. So they treat it somehow to make it water-resistant. I need to take this watch diving and see if the leather strap gets totally destroyed or what it does, because I doubt it. I must say I doubt it, but I let the Spinnaker have the benefit of the doubt with this leather strap. I put this watch on my time grapher. So I think this Seiko NH35A movement actually does a very nice job. So you get an accuracy between 5 and 10 seconds. It all depends on which positions you put the watch in. So on average, you will get maybe plus between 6 and 8 seconds a day, which is perfectly fine for a watch at this price range. And let me tell you the price, that's almost the best part of it all. So this sells at Spinnaker's website for $285. Use the code down. I got a code from Spinnaker, so you can get some discounts if you're a viewer of Watch On Channel. And let me tell you, sapphire crystal, quite accurate Seiko NH35A movement, high quality leather strap, signed buckle, all the details, super nice dial, crazy lume, all of that, and a very nice case finishing. What I think is quite amazing is that Spinnaker, they actually use Seiko movement to make a better watch, which is more affordable than a lot of Seiko's watches. So actually Spinnaker are in many ways just surpassing Seiko in quality for the money. And this is a quality dive watch. I must say I'm very surprised. I've been eyeballing Spinnaker for a long time and I have been seeing a lot of reviews, but I never experienced one until they contacted me to ask if I wanted to do a review of one of their watches. And with this Breitner dive watch from Spinnaker, I'm very, very impressed. I think they did a great job. It's a great deal. It's a fun watch. It's quite accurate. It's really well built in sapphire crystal and all of those details. So why not have a look at the lume? So look at this lume on the Spinnaker Breitner. It's absolutely crazy. This is up there with Citizen and Seiko. They did a great job, and I just really like how everything just lights up, torches up, and looms up on this Spinnaker Breitner watch. Of course, also a wrist shot. So this is how the Spinnaker Breitner 42mm dive watch looks on my wrist. And let's just take it down a notch so you can actually see how it wears on my wrist from a distance. So I have a 7 to 7.1 inch wrist size, which is approximately 18 centimeters in the metric system. And as you can see, it fits me perfectly. It is rather a large watch, and also because you don't get the typical external bezel, but it's all internal in this watch, it just gives it a very big face, so it wears bigger than a lot of watches. But if you have a wrist size approximately down to 6.5 inches, then you can easily pull this watch off, in my opinion. But you don't. If you go below 6.5, I think you should really consider another watch than this Spinnaker Breitner, because it is a big watch and it's also quite thick, as you see. But it wears really nicely, and I think it has a lot of wrist presence, and it's a fun watch. It really has a lot of details, and I'm really just a big fan of the hands. These kind of almost kind of a snowflake inspired hand, like the Tudor snowflake. The orange pop on the second hand. And also, I'm a big fan of the applied big rectangular hour markings on the inner part of the dial. It's just such a nice watch to wear and so fun to wear, in my opinion. So all in all, I really don't have too much bad to say about this watch. Of course, like always, we could have wished for a better movement. I'm a bit tired of the Seiko 35-8 movement, but it's still a very honest movement, and you get a watch below $200 if you use the discount code. So what more can you ask for? You get a workhorse movement. It's seen millions and millions and millions of watches, and actually Spinnaker used this movement to make a better watch than Seiko could make at this price point. Maybe they could also have signed the secondary crown. Why not sign both crowns instead of just one? Yeah, maybe they could have made the watch a little less thick, just pull off a few millimeters. But still, all in all, a very nice package at $285 if you just buy it at retail at Spinnaker's website. You can find the link down below. Or if you use the discount code, of course, I always ask the different watch companies for a discount code. All in all, I'm really impressed with the Spinnaker Breitner dive watch. Have a look at the website. You can get 5 or 6 different versions. So if you don't like the color combination of this one, you can definitely find another watch. It is kind of a grayish, brownish, blackish sunburst dial, and that's maybe not for everybody to enjoy. I hope you enjoyed the review of this Spinnaker Breitner watch. I hope to have the chance to review many more Spinnaker watches, because I think they do a really nice job with the watches. I'm definitely very impressed with the first one here. I just want to say thank you so much for watching my channel during 2018. I'm surpassed 7,500 subscribers and more than 2 million views. I'm super happy. Thank you so much, guys. Remember to subscribe to my channel. Hit the button down below. Give me a comment down below. Follow me on Instagram and Facebook, and I will be back with a lot more reviews. Bye.